town. And in its centre, we are here at the Wareham Town Museum for the grand reopening. Welcome to all who are here today to look at this wonderful exhibition of Wareham's heritage. God save the Queen.
Queen.
Lilian Ladle, I think, will come and give us a few words.
Thank you. I don't think I have said, I have a loud voice, but I don't think it is anywhere like yours. Right, we're here today to mark the occasion of 40 years of Wareham Town Council's involvement with this museum. Now, I don't really know, but the urge to collect and to hoard things, it's not new. It's been going on. As an archaeologist, I find things that people have gathered 2,000 years ago that were then 2,000 years old, and they saved and collected. But in Wareham, I think, actually, we don't celebrate the fact that the Reverend John Hutchins, who was rector of Lady St. Mary, was perhaps the first person to collect all the information about the county of Dorset in the 18th century. And he did it here in our town. We ought to be incredibly proud of that fact. Clerics they had this collecting urge. And in the Victorian period, we had one particular cleric, Reverend Selwyn Bennett, who was an avid collector. And when graves were being dug in the churchyard at Lady St. Mary, behind the church, he was there ferreting about and picking up all sorts of antiquities, particularly Roman pottery. And much of that collection is actually here in Wareham Museum. So if you look at some of the Roman pottery, some of that was collected in the Victorian period. That was the first town's public collection, and it was on display in the church. And then we moved to the 1960s, and we had a town mayor, a chap called Harry Broughton, who was a very keen local historian. In fact, he wrote a little book about the town when he was alive, and he amassed a collection of Wareham material, both artifacts and pictures and papers. And he opened the front room of his house, which was the manse in North Street next to the Methodist Church, and that was our real first town museum. Now, when Harry Broughton felt that he'd sort of collected so much and it was time to hand the material on, the town council became responsible for this. And in 1974, premises were acquired on St. John's Hill. In fact, it was the old fire station. Go there today, you won't see it, because Hemsback Court stands on the site. But Harry Broughton's collection was largely displayed there. And in 1984, all the building that we're standing in, and which goes east of where we are, this building went up in the 1960s, and it was built as the Wareham Town Council offices. And in 1984, the offices moved up to Westport House, and the museum was given, in fact, I think it was just a sort of single room at the end of this building, and where the entrance is, this was the Tourist Information Bureau. So this is where the museum, as we see it, in 1984, all started. Now, museums, particularly this one, has always been run by volunteers. And I have to add, it's always been run on a shoestring budget. When you go in, there's very, very little money. The museum have been fortunate in that grants have been available and acquired and made use of, but much of what you see has been done on next to nothing, mostly nothing. There have been a string of dedicated curators who've given large amounts of time and energy ensuring that the collections have been displayed and looked after to the highest standards. And Louise in front of us is the latest of a long line, but I really feel like I ought to mention Mike O'Hara, who in fact was in the job for 22 years, which by anyone's standard is a huge period of time to give up. And much of what you see today actually has Mike's stamp on it. So thank you in his absence to Mike for all the work and all the hours that he gave to this museum. And of course, there are all sorts of unnamed volunteers, the people who come in and man the desk and have been doing so for the last 40 years, who give up their time on a regular basis to ensure that this little museum is open for people to come in. Now, museums must continually develop, and this summer, I'm pleased to say that there are going to be new displays and exciting temporary exhibitions. And not only for this summer, but a programme, a future programme, is in the process of being planned. And we look forward to a World War I exhibition to celebrate the anniversary of the First World War in July, I believe that is, Louise. And I have to say that the Saxon sword is now with us again. And if you haven't seen it, have a look, because although we're a Saxon town, there is very, very little material evidence for Saxon activity within the town itself. Now, this museum displays our local heritage. And it's not just for visitors. We assume it's where, in fact, I've sent, someone's coming later on this morning. We've just had a cup of coffee and she's coming at 11. But it's for residents and local people as well. And I doubt that a tiny proportion of the people who live in our area actually come to visit this museum. You tend to come on your own. You tend to bring your grandchildren, and that's it. But this museum has continual changing displays, and it's worthwhile coming in at least once a year. Please support our museum. Now, a little bit of publicity. Ben Buxton has organised on Saturday the 26th of April a day. And in the morning, there will be lectures and talks, and it's called Digging Deeper, and it's to celebrate Wareham's long and very important heritage. And in the afternoon, there will be a walk around the town led by the chap who did one of the first proper archaeological investigations in the town in 1974, Professor David Hinton of Southampton University. It's only £3, so a huge value for money. So after I've got the commercial out of the way, I'd just like to thank everyone, both members of the Town Council who support the museum and those dedicated volunteers who actually manage to keep this place going. It's our heritage, support it, and thank you.